Hello, students. Yesterday we discussed about Maxwell's displacement current. And today we are going to start review of Maxwell's equation. And for the review of Maxwell's equation, it is described in two forms. Number one, differential form, and then Maxwell's equation in integral form. Only formula. So Maxwell gave a set of fundamental equations describing the electric and magnetic fields and their interaction with charges and currents. These equations are known as Maxwell's equations. Maxwell proposed that there is a production of magnetic field due to charging electric field. And how much magnetic field is produced due to changing electric field? It has already been discussed in class 12th or in of intermediate section. In the same manner as an electric field is produced due to a changing magnetic field, that is described in Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So, first Maxwell's equation is the Gauss's law for electrostatics, and it states that divergence vector E is equal to del dot E, and that is equal to rho by epsilon naught. Let it be equation number one. This law signifies that the electric flux through a closed surface is equal to the total charge enclosed by the closed surface. Number two Maxwell equation is Gauss's law Gauss's law for magnetostatics. Here we use a term electric flux. What is electric flux? Electric flux is the number of total electric lines of force passes through a surface which are perpendicular to the surface, in a direction perpendicular to the surface, and it is denoted by phi, and it is a scalar quantity which is equal to vector E dot vector A, where vector E is electric field intensity and vector A is area vector in a direction perpendicular to the surface. So for number one, Gauss's law for electrostatics, one has to sound knowledge of electric flux. Number two is Gauss's law for magnetism, and it states that mathematical statement is divergence vector B, denoted as vector del dot vector B, is equal to zero. This law signifies that a magnetic pole does not exist. Number three Maxwell's equation is called Maxwell's Ampere's circuital law, and it states that vector del cross vector B equal to mu naught vector J plus mu naught epsilon naught delta E by delta T. And this now becomes, put this epsilon naught inside, mu naught vector J plus mu naught del epsilon naught vector E by del T. Now we know that vector D equal to epsilon naught E, where vector D is called displacement vector in free space. So it becomes now mu naught vector J plus mu naught del vector D by del T. Let it be equation 3. What this law signifies? As a statement, this law signifies that a changing electric field produces a changing magnetic field, and this changing magnetic field produces a changing electric field. Fourth Maxwell's equation is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. It is a, this Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, basic of this is taught in intermediate section, and it states that Its mathematical statement is vector del cross vector E equal to minus vector B del vector B by del T. Let it be equation 4. What this law signifies? This law signifies that electric field is set up due to the changing electric field. These are the four Maxwell's equation, but in free space vector J equal to 0 and rho is also equal to 0 in free space. So Maxwell's equations in this case are written as del dot E equal to 0, because del dot E equal to rho by epsilon naught. Since rho equal to 0, it becomes 0. Del dot B equal to 0, already explained. And del cross B equal to mu naught epsilon naught del vector E by del T. And del cross vector E, these are also called curl B, curl E as a mathematical statement, equal to minus del vector B by del T. Till now we have discussed Maxwell's equations in free space. Now we are going to discuss the differential form of Maxwell's equations in matter, or you can say in a medium. For this, we have the following equations for a linear homogeneous isotropic medium. That is, vector J equal to sigma vector E, vector D equal to epsilon vector E, where epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. And as you know that this epsilon is epsilon naught epsilon R. For air, epsilon R equal to 1, that is relative permittivity. Therefore, for air or vacuum or free space, it is called absolute permittivity and denoted as epsilon 0. Whereas epsilon 0 is written, it means this is for air or free space or in vacuum. And vector B equal to mu vector H, where mu is called permeability. Let it be equation number 6. So Maxwell's equation in matter or medium can be written as number 1. Number 1 Maxwell equation is Gauss's law for electrostatics. This now be written as vector del dot vector E equal to rho by epsilon naught, or this epsilon comes here, so it becomes vector del dot epsilon vector E equal to rho, or epsilon vector E is vector D, so del vector dot vector D equal to rho. Let it be equation 7. Number 2 Maxwell equation is Gauss's law for magnetostatics, and it is the same thing, vector del dot vector B equal to 0. Let it be equation 8. Number 3 is called Maxwell Ampere's circuital law, and this is del cross B for medium or matter, mu vector J plus mu del D by del T, or vector del cross mu vector H, right? And mu is taken as common here, vector J plus del D by del T. Mu and nu cancel out, and therefore it becomes, because vector B is equal to mu vector H, it has been written here. So put the value of B here, mu mu cancel out, so del cross H equal to vector J plus del D by del T. Let it be equation number 9. Number 4 is Faraday's law of electromagnetic inductance. All these equations, that is from 7, 8, 9, and now I am going to talk about equation 10. So all these four equations are the Maxwell's equation in differential form in a matter, or you can say in medium. So it becomes del cross E equal to minus del vector B by del T, equation 10. So till now we have discussed the Maxwell's equation in vacuum, matter, that is in differential form. which is written in my heading before starting today's lecture. Now, these Maxwell's equations are also used in integral form. Of course, there is derivation, but derivation is not required here. Only you have to know the formulas of Maxwell's equation integral form. All these formulas will be used in the later chapter of electromagnetic theory. So, just I am dictating this. Thus, Maxwell's equation in integral form are written as, number one, surface integral of displacement vector, that is, this is over a closed surface. This is called surface integral of displacement vector over a closed surface is equal to integral over the whole volume rho dV, number one. That is for Gauss's law of electrostatics. Number two is surface integral of magnetic field vector over a closed surface is equal to zero. I have written here only the formula. Number three, Maxwell's Ampere circuital law, surface in, line integral of vector H over a closed surface is equal to surface integral of vector J plus del D by del T dot ds, vector ds. And number four, Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction in integral form is line integral of the electric field vector over a closed surface is equal to the differential of surface integral of magnetic field vector. That is, in mathematical form, it is written as minus d by dt integral over s vector b dot vector ds. Consider all these four equations 1, 2, 3, 4 as equation capital A. I have written here equation capital A. In my later lecture, whenever I said using equation A means you have to use these equations as the case may be. So this is all about our review of Maxwell's equation, which I have been started for today's lecture. Next day I will discuss about the scalar potential and vector potential in electromagnetic theory. This will be discussed in our next lecture. So wish you all the best and thank you. At this moment I have to say that we all are suffering from a great epidemic. एक बहुत बड़े महामारी से पूरा विश्व गुजर रहा है और इस महामारी को रोकने का कोई चूंकि मेडिसिन नहीं है, दवा नहीं है, वैक्सीनेशन नहीं है, इसकी एक ही दवा है जो कि हमें घर में रहना है, जिसके चलते हम लोग ये कोशिश कर रहे हैं छात्रों के लिए कि आप लोग कम से कम अपने पढ़ाई को कंटिन्यू रखिए, समस्या चाहे जो भी हो अपना काम तो करना ही है और कोई भी चुनौती को साहस से सामना करना है जो सबको मिलकर हम लोग सामना कर रहे हैं। आप छात्र हैं, आपके ऊपर अपना कैरियर, समाज, देश का बहुत बड़ा दायित्व है, आप ही को संभालना है। हम शिक्षक आप लोगों को हर तरह से मदद के लिए तैयार हैं, सरकार भी है, आप जैसे सभी जगह हर जगह टीवी में प्रशासन की तरफ से कहा जा रहा है स्टे होम एंड बी हेल्दी, इसको कठोरता से पालन कीजिए और कभी भी बाहर निकलने कोशिश अपने भी मत निकलिए, अपने दोस्तों को समझाइए। ये बहुत बड़ा दायित्व है, देशभक्ति का एक बहुत बड़ा मौका मिला है सबों को, आपको, हमको, सबों को। आप इस देश के कर्णधार हैं, आप पर बहुत उम्मीद है, आप चाहे तो इसको चुटकी में इस समस्या को सॉल्व कर सकते हैं। अपने पढ़ाई को चालू रखिए और मैं क्या कहूं, आपको खुद ही सब कुछ मालूम है। मैं कोशिश करूंगा कि आपका क्लासेस भी चलते रहें और मैं आपका जो भी है हम देते रहें, पढ़ाते रहें और पढ़ाएंगे भी, और
जो भी हम लोगों से करना पड़ रहा है हम लोग कर रहे हैं, आपको भी अपनी दायित्व को समझना है। लेकिन आपको कोई भी समस्या हो तो कॉलेज तो खुलेगी ही, समस्या है तो समाधान होगा ही, हम कॉलेज जाएंगे, आप बेहिचक हमसे आकर सारे लेक्चर के बारे में हमसे पूछ सकते हैं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, और आप लोग स्वस्थ रहें, मस्त रहें, मेहनत करें घर से बाहर होने के लिए, बस इतनी ही विनती है। थैंक यू।